Hey parents, chances are you've been hearing about IYC, but you might be wondering, what is it? All you've heard is it's some big long trip to San Antonio this summer and it's gonna cost you about $1,000. Now, if I were you, I'd be wanting to know a little more about it and why you should be sending your student to go. I totally get that. So IYC is International Youth Convention, and it's a 4-day convention of middle school and high school students and their adult leaders, of course. It's held every other year and it rotates around the country. It was canceled in 2020, of course, which is why we're super excited to go this summer. IYC is an opportunity for life change. Now, I know, we throw around that phrase a whole lot. Heck, I just had a taco the other day that nearly changed my life. But I promise you, we experience God in unique ways at events like this. Let me put it this way. As your kid's youth pastor, I know full well that your student does not remember every message I give. Heck, they probably don't remember what I talk about 10 minutes later. But I teach in a way that hopefully nurtures their faith and understanding of God over time as they become more and more involved in youth here. And then there are certain events like weekend retreats and trips like IYC that are catalysts for their growth. They're concentrated experiences that can serve as milestone markers for them. They're away from home, outside their normal routines, surrounded by their friends and tons of people and adults who love and care about them. Using myself as an example, I'm 34 years old now, and I can still vividly remember my two IYC trips to Denver in 2002 and Anaheim in 2006. In addition to the gradual weekly growth I experienced in my youth group, those IYC trips helped shape me into who I am today. So what specifically will your student experience at IYC this summer in San Antonio? While we're still fine-tuning a few details, this trip will deepen your students' understanding of the world around them as they experience other cultures. They'll hear from a diverse group of speakers as they learn about who God is, who they're created to be, and the purpose God has for their lives. They'll hear awesome live music. They'll have a blast at Six Flags and on the beach at the Gulf of Mexico. All while strengthening the relationships as a youth group as we all experience this life-changing trip together. Finally, I know trips like this are a significant chunk of change, which is why we will be having fundraisers soon, so stay tuned for details. And I do want you to hear this clearly from me. While trips like this do cost money, I never, ever want the cost of something to keep anyone from going. If there are other factors that means a student can't go, I get that. But please let me know if you ever need some financial assistance and we will work something out. I understand that can be hard to talk about, but know that my door is always open and we'll find a way for your student to go if they want to go. Well, hey, if you ever have any questions, call or text me anytime, and I hope to see your student go with us to IYC this summer. Oh, and if you'd like to see some highlights from our last trip to IYC and right here in Indianapolis in 2018, I've attached it to this video, so keep watching.
His ghost is a fire, a holy flame burning wild. Burning through the night, burning with the light of a billion stars. His love is like lightning, cracking through the sky, burning through the rage, burning through the pain of a billion scars. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. All the stories are true. His ghost is inside me, holy fire burning wide.
when you're in a circumstance where you can't change your circumstance, I want you to know that I am not here at this convention to say, well, I have no arms and legs. What are you going through? Wrong. And I want you to know that you can have arms and legs and you can have things, and there are times that you can be happy, but when you know in your soul there's something missing, you're lacking joy.
Disappointed in you, that God not looks at you and is like, oh, not that person again, not that one again, that God looks at you with literally pure love, that God only loves you, that God sees past all of your sin. That's the whole point. Listen to me.